What's up, brohams? This is Colonel Twerkins. If you've never been to my channel before, I do gameplay videos on games like Contract Wars, which is a browser-based game, the soon-to-be-released Escape from Tarkov, and DC Universe Online. Today I'm going to be showing you how to manage your subtitles and add closed captions. Let's go.
Twerk. Machine gun on fleet. Machine gun on.
Okay. So first step is you want to go to the video in question and you want to go to subtitles here. You can access this from your actual video by clicking on the little down arrow drop box next to edit on each of the videos on your video manager page and click on subtitles here. So now that you have it, you have English, which if you've never added subtitles, it'll ask you what language do you want to set it to first. A little window will pop up and you will put English or whatever your language is. So what it does then is it tries to sync some subtitles to it, and typically they don't work. At least they don't come out. See? Oh, he probably spawned a year was being 10 new pal. It doesn't always add up, right? So what we want to do next is we want to go ahead and click add new subtitles. I want to click English in my case. And then you have three options here. You have upload a file, transcribe and auto sync, and then you have create new subtitles or closed captions. Unless you really want to, I would just stay away from that. There's no point in using that. Upload a file is basically only if you have an SRT file or the other file types that can be used. And that means that it's already prepared with time syncing. Like it says this line goes in at this time, etc., etc. Well, since we're doing this straight from the bottom, right, I don't have one. So what we're going to do is we're going to go to the next option, which is transcribe and auto sync. Once you get to this, it's going to say type what's spoken here, which is your script. Now, if you don't have a script, I'll give you another option for that here in a second. But right away, since I do have something to put in here, which is not the script, I'm just putting some random text that I have. Okay, I'm going to control all, then control C for copy. I'm going to come here, control V for paste. Now that I've gotten it in here, it doesn't matter the spaces and all the pausing. It's not, I'm going to tell you now, since the words don't match, it's not going to actually probably be able to do it, to sync it correctly, right? So I'm going to go ahead and hit set timings, right? And eventually, if you click the refresh, it's going to tell you subtitle timings are being set, check back soon. Okay, so now let's go to another video that I've already done, and then I'll show you how I did it from there. Okay, so now I'm back and I'm on my Escape from Tarkov skills update video, and I have add new subtitles. Okay, but what I did was after I already installed, transcribed, sorry, the text from my script, what I then did was, we can go back here and look at it again. Okay, let's see here, go ahead and click this drop down arrow, subtitles here. Okay, and what you would do is let's go to this old one here, right? Is once you have it in there, right, and it's finished syncing it up, which this is the original version that the video actually does on its own, or that YouTube does, and it doesn't match. What you would do is you go to actions, and then you would download, right? Now, typically, this menu, once it's done, you would, it would have more options. It would say download, and then it would be a sub menu that would say the file that you want. I generally go with SRT. So once you get here, you don't click on download, you would just click on SRT, and that would actually download that file for you. Okay, so this is an SBV file, so these haven't been set. I haven't published the edits yet. So let's say I publish the edits now. We're gonna go ahead and publish them. Okay, so now what I would do is go to English, then I would come here and I would go to SRT, and then I would have those there, and I would save them wherever I'd like to, but I would name them whatever I want, right? Once I save that file, okay, so let's get back out of here. Let's exit. Okay, now once I have that file, then I'd come over here, and I already have it set up. I'll leave links to anything that I go to. Okay, so upload SRT file. Okay, now this is a website I go to because it really is the easiest one for me to use. Hopefully it stays around for a while, but you could either drag and drop the file or click to upload, and I'll click to upload here. So let's say for this video, I would want to, I already have a subs folder, and it already has that English version set in it. Okay, I would open it up. Now I have the original, and then I have translated text. What I would then do is start to pick another language to use, right? So let's just say Croatian, right? Now I know that Google is not known for having the best translations, but if you don't speak the other language, then what can you do? You have to do the best that you can. And let me tell you something. I'm right now, to this date, I have not had one complaint about the subtitles that I use in another language. People often thank me for them and appreciate it. And I've gotten subs from people who, once they read them, and had no knew that they were there, they could kind of gravitate between the English and their language in the subtitles, and they would get a really good understanding of the video, and they appreciate that. So once you do this, you don't need to highlight anything. You're just going to click save as, and when you do this, you will go to your video, okay, and you would then click on, and that's, since I already have a name for it, I would back this up and I would just put Crow for short. I would click save, and now that it's saved, right, I'd come back here and I'd click add new subtitles, search Croatian, then I would click upload a file, choose the Croatian file, click upload. And sometimes you may want to check to make sure, because like I have an intro in my video, okay, this space, sometimes it doesn't do that. It lets it run the whole time, so you would just adjust that. Now the way you would adjust that, so let's say it was doing it all the way to here, right, So now let's go back and look at what it does. See, stays there the whole time. You don't want that. So of course you can come here, grab these handles. These handles are really tricky to use though. So I would go, and the trick is really easy. You would look where the audio is down here. This is a waveform. I spent a lot of years doing audio engineering. So the waveforms will tell you, okay? They'll tell you. So the intro is the music that when it comes in, it usually starts from a low volume, gets really high, and then goes out, and it's small. So if you notice, you can tell by just looking at it, right? So now, and then it would end. This is the music, and this waveform right here tells you that the voice is about to start. And if you needed to line it up, you'd have that to tell you how to do it. So once you do that, it's not that hard. You can also sit through the video and watch it and make sure that they switch from title to title appropriately, okay? But now that that's done, I can click publish and I'm done. Pretty simple, right? But let's say that you did not or were not able to do a script, right? But you still wanted to do subtitles. Okay, so the next thing you could try is there's one of two options. One, I use something called Word Counter. I don't use it anymore right now, but I did it at one time. And sometimes if I want to do this method, I might use it. But I would go and you click more and talk to type. Requires Chrome, so just remember that. Done. So now this is the talk to type. So I would just click this and hold it and say, "What's up? This is Colonel Twerkins." See, it doesn't fix it and go. So once you do that, then you would have. You could either do this just to do a script if you wanted to ahead of time, go back and correct anything, or in the case of a video that's already done, what I do is I use this, or I use Google Docs, which is the other thing I use, and I actually take, since I have headphones, I let the video play and I take my microphone from my headset and I put it over the ear, not on it, but over the ear of the headphones, and let it dictate to itself, basically, you know. And of course you will have to go back and correct some things, but once you do that, it's way easier, trust me, than having to go back and try to type it all yourself, unless you have those kind of skills, then by all means. So what I do is I use Google Documents to talk to type, and this is the way I use it. And I use this one mainly for scripts, because you can't seem to get it to do the things that I can do with Word Counter as far as for videos that have already been done but don't have a script, which I'll show you that in a minute. So voice to typing, pretty simple. You just click on it, start talking. You know, today's video is going to be about flowers, and not just any flowers, stinky flowers. Okay, so you'd have that. Everybody pretty much knows about voice typing. Okay, so that's what you would do for scripts. It makes it a whole lot easier. You just go back and correct some stuff, and then boom, Bob's your uncle. You're ready to go. But for actual videos where you want to capture what it says, you know, okay. This is what I do. Let me see if this will work. Hopefully it's still working the same way. Okay. Click the talk to type. And if you can't find the talk to type when you first start, Like I said, you just click more and make sure that talk to type is on. You must have Chrome in order to use this feature, unless you find some other program or some other website that does it based on your browser. And you know what I mean. Okay, so you would click on talk to type. Okay, apparently it didn't do it right, so we're gonna do it again. See? So, yeah, of course it has, you know, some mistakes there, and then we can just continue. Well, it stopped because it does have a timeout, so you can get only so much done at a time, and then you just click it again and do it. But in the end, if you try to do this all by hand, I mean, it's gonna just take a whole lot longer and it's gonna be aggravating. So it makes, especially if you are serious about YouTube and you are trying to like get a lot of videos done, I mean, you need to cut time somewhere as much as you can. And this is one thing that will do it. So now we already have our published closed caption and subtitle, etc. And that's pretty much it. I mean, you know, it's pretty easy once you get the hang of doing it. I mean, you see here, I'm adding all sorts of languages just to cover my bases. But once you get it, it's so easy to just go here, or click to another translation, and then boom, there you go. And then click save as, and so on and so forth. Also, another option you can do here is if you just don't have the time to do it, but you do have a community that is willing to do it, you can click this here, community contributions. I already have it on, but you can then give a link, which is here, and that will allow them to go in and correct your subtitles. So if someone is getting snarky about it, and they say, oh, this is not correct, and you know, whatever, say, hey, well, could you do me a favor? You know, if I give you a link, would you go in and correct it for me? A lot of times if you ask them like that, they'll say yes, and then you'll have it all taken care of. But anyway, I think this is something that a few people have been asking me about, and I decided I would do this. And I would like to say I appreciate you watching, and if you could, a lot of people would like to know stuff like this, and maybe they don't know how to find it or whatever, but liking the video will help them do that. Also, you can share it on your social media, Twitter, Facebook, and that will help out a lot as well. And I would appreciate that support so much, as well as subscribing if you want more tips or you just want to see more of my videos, you enjoy what I do. I'd really appreciate that. All right, thanks a lot, guys. Peace.